And so I found out about the platform itself from a friend of mine who was working on a project, a nonprofit project with me. And they had been connected with a mentor and they thought it was a great idea if I needed the same thing, because when you're doing something new, you don't know what you don't know. I knew I needed help, but I didn't know how to find it or how to find somebody that was trustworthy or knew even how to help me. So they, a friend of mine, directed me, guided me to the platform itself. And I was familiar with Talent Stacker. I had done the 5-day challenge in the very beginning of my Salesforce journey. And so I knew what the sort of the branding of Talent Stacker was. I went over there and it was actually surprisingly maybe too easy to find a mentor, because all of a sudden, without hesitation or wanting to being able to chicken out, you're finding a mentor and you're already connected.
So I've been following Talent Stacker for probably over 4 years. I love the community. I love what it stands for. It's cool to watch it grow, right? And so when I saw the mentorship opportunity come up, I was like, that's awesome. Because I think it's a hard thing, right? You're already nervous, you're in a new role, and it's really odd to just like reach out to somebody on LinkedIn or go to an email and just like send a cold call out and like hope that you guys like vibe or jive or whatever it may be. That was a really good thing where I was like, okay, cool. I never really had a mentor. And so the easiest way to explain like why is that I never had one and I always wanted one. And I didn't know how to bridge that gap. Like I'm like, I have a problem. I don't know where to find a solution for it. And so when I saw this, I was like, okay, cool. Like I've been in the ecosystem for over a decade now. So I was like, well, I think this is time where I can contribute. Like I can give back now. And so that was the first thing that attracted me to it. But I also think that once I got in there, I was able to really like present myself in a way of like, how can I offer help? Like, certain people only want certain things and maybe I can't always be that perfect match for them. And so being able to put myself out there and then also reading the about me's that people send, like that's what makes you match so easily. Because if you're looking for example, like a, freelancing, then I know how to help you with that. But maybe if you're looking for, working on other things like nonprofit, maybe no nonprofit as well as I would like to, but I can still help you with other things. So I think that really it's like almost a matchmaking moment there that makes it a little bit easier. It takes some of that pressure off. And that way you can say, okay, can I really help this person? Because at the end of the day, you can't really help everybody,
That's a great question. So what I love about the simplicity of the matching platform is that it gives the mentor and mentee both enough information to start out, even before the first call, with like a good framework of like, this is what this person needs, this is how this person can help, how we can help each other, right? And then before our first call, we sort of had this expectation that I was going to bring a certain amount of, my resume and my portfolio and whatever other kinds of questions I had. And I knew enough about Anna from her LinkedIn profile and from just in the short emails that we had that I knew, okay, this is the kind of person that can help me with X, I think, And you get into that first phone call and you're like, okay, I was right about these two things. And here's a surprise. Here's a good bonus I didn't know about. And Anna's the kind of person that as a great mentor, I've mentored young adults most of my adult life. And so when you're mentoring other people, you're only so far ahead of them and you can sort of warn them to the gaps and the pitfalls and maybe tell them not to worry about some things they shouldn't be worried about. And Anna was doing that for me. She had a great first of all, she's so personable and she put me at ease right away. And so I felt like I wasn't talking to somebody who had a leg up on me and was going to lecture me, but more of like a peer that knew something that I wanted to know, right? And so Anna really, she took a look at my portfolio and my resume and what trajectory I was looking for, where I wanted to be in my career in the Salesforce ecosystem. And she was like, right away, she was like, this, yes, and yes, this, no, and no. And we had immediately a direction and a trajectory for the next, short term, which was awesome. We already knew like the action plan before the meeting even ended. It was wonderful.
So I think that when I first started on the platform, I think it was the platform was a little bit newer. Some of the people were a little bit newer. And so absolutely, I didn't know what to expect. And my first couple of calls that I had with my first round of mentees is it was very question-based. Like I had those questions, I needed questions that they were asked. And so I tried to stay onto those questions as much as possible. What I quickly learned is that we went off the rails because every single person wanted to remain different. They were in different portions of their career. They may have prepped more. They may have needed just interview prep. So we didn't have to go through like resume and all that because they already had an interview. So I think that, you know, understanding that meeting people where they're at was a skill that I pretty quickly, because normally, you know, 9 out of 10 times in the first 5 to 10 minutes of our call, I can kind of understand like, if you do the assignments, are you for an assignment? How does that kind of, you know, mesh? And then what's really cool about what I get to do is I get to meet people from all over the world too. Like right now I'm working with somebody from Nigeria, working with somebody from Turkey. And there's a really interesting like cultural balance that you have to kind of understand of like, okay, do these questions make sense for your area? Like if you're looking for a role overseas, some of the things don't apply. And so kind of just understanding that every single person is different. So what I actually did, I've taken like all the things or questions or anything that anybody's asked me, and I've tried to compile like a little like FAQ. And then that way, if somebody comes, you know, because some people just come to the meeting and they're so nervous about the first time talking to somebody that they're like, they don't know what to say. So they don't know how to lead that conversation. And so without knowing much about them, you know, being able to just talk them through just like, what are you looking to get out of this? And it's okay just to have an hour call of venting. Like it's absolutely okay. And so I think I just, you know, gotten that experience of like understanding to meet people where they're at and make them feel super comfortable. And some people are more technical, some people are less technical. And I get to really learn a lot about myself in this moment too. I get to learn like patience, or even better, like I get to hear the advice I give to somebody and I get to have that advice too. That's a big part of this. It's like, I hear other people's problems and I'm like, oh, how would I solve it? And now I get a tool for my future of how I potentially would solve it if I was in that situation. So it's a really cool, like, giving back situation there.
I'll go first if you, that's okay. So what I love about that particular question is you can see yourself as a milepost for somebody else, because it's true. I am further ahead than somebody who is just starting out, right? And the great thing about this particular platform is that it sort of encapsulates everything that's great about the Salesforce ecosystem, Ohana. And that is, you know, when I first started, that people talk about how everybody helps each other and you're like, okay, sure. Like that's a nice platitude. But the truth is most people in the ecosystem do want to help each other. They're not seeing each other strictly as competition, but as we see here in this platform, we can see people saying like, hey, I'm further along, let me help you. Or even if like Anna is further along than me, somebody else is further along than Anna in whatever particular thing she wants to pursue. And so she can go to somebody else as her milepost further ahead, right? And one of the great things about that is, you know, that it's possible, you know, that even if you feel like an imposter, like somebody else also felt like an imposter and they still did it. You still put one foot in front of each of the other and you still keep going in that direction. And one of the great things about meeting Anna is that, you know, even though I know she's further along than I am and she has more expertise in these areas, she also is relatable and she's a regular person. You know, meeting her like on Zoom, I was like, oh, she's a person, like a human, and I don't have to be intimidated. And it, you know, to sort of cliche, but if she can do it, I can do it, you know, kind of a thing. And like, these are just regular people. They're not rock stars. They're not like, you know, have the IQ of whoever, Mensa, whatever, you know what I mean? Like, but Anna is sharp. She's done this before and I can do it too. And so it sort of inspires you to be like, all these people are doing this and they're regular people and I can do this too.
There's these interesting paths in the ecosystem that there's certifications for and all those things. My whole career was not linear. It's not like I'm a product manager. Like I'm building products from nothing to something on Salesforce. And so that's not like a certification or a path that you can just like follow. So a lot of people I work with are like, hey, I like these 5 things. Where do I belong? And it's like, well, you don't have to put a title on yourself. You don't have to say, I'm just an admin. You can say, oh, I like doing these things. So maybe customer success is for you. or maybe like demoing or training is for you, and being able to talk through that with people and being like, you don't have to just be in the admin bucket or the consultant bucket or the architect bucket. Like, there's different paths. That's another thing that I think mentorship is really good for, because you're helping people align with other opportunities that they can either create for themselves, especially if they're in like a small business where it's like, imagine coming to your boss and saying, hey, here's things I'm really good at, and here's how it values to the business, and then here's my value to the business based on these things. It's so much better than like, can I have a title upgrade? Can I have this? Like, it's a different, you know, conversation. And so I think that that's part of it too, is that going through that process of understanding like, what do you like, right? It doesn't have to always be certifications and technical things and that are like very like vanilla based things. It could be a lot more than that. And also something that Christy and I shared is like, you know, I just want to be transparent. Like, I suffer from being like not looking through a whole thing of like trying to public speak better, where like I'm going through anxiety and working through all of these things. And Christy is really good at that. So now I become the mentee in that moment where we're talking about like, okay, I'm about to go do my first improv, and we can share that together. Or we're talking about, I just did my first event, and we're celebrating that together. So it's like one of those things where it's not just like Christy's like, okay, I'm learning from somebody and I got to go do all this homework. I have homework. I have challenges that she's challenging me too. So it's a really nice, you know, give and take in that sense.
As somebody who was thinking about getting a mentor, I wanted to be in a position where I could benefit the most from seeking a mentor. So that wouldn't have been me 2 years ago, just starting out. It needed to be me, you know, an iteration of me that was ready to receive some guidance and be able to show what I've done so far and sort of be in a place where I felt stuck, because I do feel stuck in the moment where I am now. And but I'd done the prep work beforehand. I wasn't just going into it saying, okay, I'm brand new, show me what to do. I've never done this before. I don't know the ecosystem at all. I haven't even opened a Trailhead. So guide me, hold my hand and guide me. Instead, it was I had put in some work of my own and had gotten to a place where I was like, okay, I feel like I need a guide. And I think going in, if you're feeling tentative or nervous or scared, first of all, it's okay to feel that way. You can feel vulnerable. It can feel pretty vulnerable to go to somebody and say, hey, I need help. And, you know, here's my resume. It may look, you may get some criticisms back or some, you know, advice. And that's sometimes hard to take, especially if you're feeling nervous about it. But I would say if you're in a place where you are ready for a mentor, just do it. What harm can come from meeting somebody new? The only thing that can happen is you might hear some criticism you don't want to hear, but I would say most of it will be good for you and you'll grow from it. So if you're feeling hesitant, just feel hesitant and do it anyway. Do it scared.
I think that the first thing is reading through that about me profile is I hope everybody reads that, right? Because that's really people taking the time to really like fill out who they are and what they're looking for in that. And that's the first thing before I accept anything. Like, I make sure that they took the time to write that. And then the second thing is I always make sure that I ask for the resume or portfolio or something, even, you know, resume feedback or interview feedback, something like that beforehand. That gives me some time to make some notes. I don't want it to be on the fly type thing where, especially like if I'm looking through your resume, I'm taking away time from you. And so I want to make sure I have some at least notes or better understanding of like, what is your overall picture? So I would definitely recommend, you know, taking some time to do that before the call. And then I also want like to make sure like, what are they doing on LinkedIn? So I really connect with them because I want it to be human, right? I don't want it to feel like bot to bot connection or a forced connection. I like to engage with them on LinkedIn beforehand because that way I can see, hey, are they active on LinkedIn? Do they even have one? And something like that, something as simple as that, of just like, hey, why don't you just sign up for LinkedIn and we can stay connected? That creates a bond and a trust with people. And then oftentimes people will come asking questions about like, yeah, I saw this post. Can you tell me more about this? Or I would like to make a post. Can you give me some more feedback about this? And I think that a lot of people not be so stressed about like, as a mentor, you want to make sure you're giving people value back. Like, you're spending an hour with me. I don't want to just spend it and like waste your time. So I think that making sure that you have a value to give back, instead of just being quiet and listening, being prepared to do that and meet that person where they're at, I definitely would recommend that. Just not having an agenda, because the first time I had an agenda and we covered none of this. And I was like, well, as long as they got something out of it, I love that. And so I think that flexibility too, being able to just say, where are you at? How can I help you? And just being able to just do the thing, whatever they ask for. I think that that's really what allows you to be open to making it naturally flow, right? Because none of this needs to be forced. And that's the hardest thing about mentorship is, oftentimes in the past, when it's a paid mentorship or it's a friend, it feels a little forced. And I think none of this ever feels forced. It's two people wanting to help each other and be part of each other's journey.